is actually interesting to me, because, of course, Cinderella has been around a lot longer than Thor, but I bet that's a situation where Thor fans are more... When you take on a property like Thor, people are probably a lot more serious about you getting it exactly right.
Well, they're incredibly passionate, fantastically enthusiastic, but they do get very worked up about where Thor's nipples might be on his suit.
Right.
Or indeed, if he has nipples. Sure. I mean, he has them. I mean, yeah. Believe he's got them. He's got them. And it's our job to rearrange them.
Right.
And that was fun.
That sounds like fun. That's why you get into the business.
Yeah, in a way, when they ask you. It's the excitement, it's the fame, it's the parties. And in my case, it was Chris Hemsworth's nipples.
Right, yeah. And when you're young...
Yeah, exactly.
And they're into it.
People who've moved them also here today.
Yeah. Or who would like to. You know, when I move them, I move them right here. Yeah. Closer the better. I would assume with Cinderella, one of the things as a director that you get asked about and you want to get exactly right is the glass slippers, which you took very seriously.
Yeah, well, Swarovski came with Sandy Powell, our amazing, many Oscar-winning costume designer. They made this very heavy, beautiful glass slipper, multifaceted, and two very impressive guys from Swarovski came along with the white gloves. And you knew when it was in the studio because you could hear the sounds of shrieking all across the lot.
You had shoe groupies. You had slipper groupies.
Big-time slipper groupies. People wanted their foot in that shoe, tell you. Because it was very valuable and you couldn't drop it. And our brilliant prince, Richard Madden from Game of Thrones, you may know, wonderful actor. Yeah, very sexy, trexy in this. But he would tease the Swarovski boys by throwing the shoe up, you know. And you could see these guys running, don't drop the slipper, please don't drop the slipper.
Well, that's hard. When you have one job, which is to come back with the slipper in one piece, you can't have any fun with someone doing a prank.
Exactly. They were gray by the time they left. They were gray.
Yeah, because if you came back with a smashed slipper and your boss said, how did it go, you couldn't say, B minus. You'd have to say it was...
Yeah. But we can rebuild it. We can rebuild it. I think a simple process of, say, a year and a half.
And we'll have it back.
Yeah, you'll never notice, except the cracks.
They'll be fine. Yeah, but that's fine. It's like grungier Cinderella.
Yeah,
she's a little more cool.
Like it's an image. She's broken. She's fractured inside. Yes. So it could be like kind of abstract.
Yeah, I like that. Yeah, we got to do a sequel now.
Thank you. Yeah, that's a good idea. Yeah. Cinderella 2, The Broken Slipper.
There you go.
I love it.
I want, at the very least, I want an associate producer's credit.
That's good. We can put it back together! That kind of thing.
Cinderella!
That kind of
thing.
That's
good. I feel like we're halfway done with the script.
Yeah, exactly. So that's the first act.
That's the first act.
The second act, I don't know, she opens a restaurant, something
probably
like that.
That's good,
That's good. Get some fun stuff there.
Yeah. And then the third act, the prince comes back and says, let's give it another go.
Yes, exactly. I'm liking this.
Yes, it's good. Okay. The first time I saw you, I was familiar with you, was when you did Henry V.
Right.
Which you directed.
Yeah, I did. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Based on a play you wrote? Had you wrote the play? I can't remember.
I can't remember. but it was, it was Henry V, so it was basically a sequel.
Yeah, you just took over. You took over the... So I remember, for me, it was the first time I saw Shakespeare on film in a way that made it seem really cool and accessible. Was that something you set out to do when you took it over?
Well, I mean, I don't know if you can ever really set out to be cool or whatever. We knew that he was, because he'd lasted 400 years. And what we had was our youth and our inexperience, and our ignorance was bliss. And we just felt passionate about it. And it was, we had an amazing group of people involved in that picture. You know, we had Dame Judi Dench. Who we've heard about.
And this, we didn't know her as well. Now I feel like we've known her forever, but that was sort
of early on. And the late, great Sam Goldwyn Jr. was a wonderful producer, but produced the movie. I remember going and saying, look, would you please put her name on the poster? Because I really think she's going to go places.
Yeah.
And he said, I think you're right. And then we had another young man in there. Who was in scenes with Judy. It was funny. He was 15 years old. And I think his name was, I don't know if he's done anything since. Christian Bale?
Christian Bale. Look at young Christian Bale.
Oh, that's funny. God. I remember it was a pretty robust production with a lot of joshing and a lot of humor always around. And I remember him coming up to me at 15 years old going, with a little look of terror on his face, saying, I've never heard swearing like this in my life. So we advanced his education, not all in all the right ways, but we did our best to be very responsible.
Well, that's wonderful, and congratulations on the film.
Thanks
I can't
so
wait
much.
To see it. So
Thanks
lovely
a lot,
to have
Seth.
You.
Thanks.
Kenneth Branagh.